Dr. Supriya here, and I am your GOQii doctor, and welcome to my show, The Good Doctor Show. And I'm very happy that you people are going to be joining me today for the discussion all about hair fall and what exactly happens and how's the hair growth also that happens in our hair. So it's going to be a discussion about that. And before I start the discussion, we have a new challenge which is started off, and you all must be aware of it. It is called as India Step Challenge. And its hashtag is Ab Chalega India. So this is our new challenge that we started off, and starting off, it's kicking off from 22nd. That is, I think, day after tomorrow. So we are starting off that challenge. So just to tell you about the challenge, it is the most basic of all the exercises that we can discuss about, and that is walking. You simply have to keep walking. You don't have to do anything major. You just have to keep walking. And basically, you have to walk to complete at least 6,000 steps per day. And this is a challenge over 100 days. Okay, so it's going to be a 100-day challenge. You have to every day finish off at least 6,000 steps. There are close to 100 levels to this, and you can open them up by, you know, you can refer a friend. You can have all this. It's a lot of fun thing that is all there inside it. So it's a little bit of a challenge. And it's going to be super fun, and all you have to do is just walk. Okay, the challenge is all about walking, of course, with your GOQii band in, and you know, you have something of GOQii, which is measuring your step challenge, so that is very important. So this is our main goal. Of course, it's going to help you in weight management, sleep, better sleep, reduction of stress, all of that is going to be along with it. So that is our new challenge. It is called as hashtag Ab Chalega India. If you are a part of it and if you want to join in, please open up the app. You all will see it. And along with that, you all can also hashtag us as hashtag GOQii and hashtag Ab Chalega India and start walking. And I think you can win up to 5 crore rupees, which is like super awesome. And the other thing is, if not, we have a lot of goodies that we're giving out. I think there's some telephones that we're giving out. And a grand prize is of 5 lakh. I don't know where I read crore. I'm so sorry. So it's 5 lakh rupees. And they are giving out fitness trackers to goodies to mobile phones as well. So do participate in this. It's going to be like super awesome. So please participate. Okay. Hi, Mr. Tilak. Thank you so much for joining in. I'm going to wait for another minute before I start on with my main conversation about hair follicles and the growth. I'm also going to show you an image, which is going to keep. I'm going to start showing you all as many images as possible because I think it really helps us out. Hi, Deepak. So every time I'm looking here, I'm just looking at the computer. All right. So I just have my notes made. And they're all out here, so I'm going to be seeing them. So it's all about hair and your hair fall and the hair growth. So we basically you would always wonder or see ki kisi aur ke baal are longer than yours and why aren't yours the same, or your friend's hair grow faster than yours and why is that not the same with you. So all of that is going to be what we can be discussing about today. Of course, your questions are always welcome. And if I do lose track, please get me back on track and tell me that, you know, this was a discussion, because I always lose track. I don't know why that happens. Every time I see a question, I want to answer it, and then it becomes I just lose track. So hi, Deepak. Hi, Manish Shah. Hi, Manish Shah. Okay, so it is exactly 5 o'clock and I see that close to 400 people have joined in. So I am going to start it off today. So I'm just going to show you in the computer the first thing. It's a laptop. Okay. This is a single hair shaft. Okay. Generally in our hair shaft, we have single follicle. No, I am a cosmetologist, but I have studied the entire thing about hair and skin. I just did not want to do the other one, but I want to do the beautification of it. So I'm a cosmetologist. And these are, hi Meenal, I hope you have amazing questions for me today as well. So these are basically your hair follicle, each single follicle. Okay, and from each follicle you can have multiple shafts. That is, this is one shaft, you can have multiples of them as well. So this is a bulb. Okay, and I'm going to be explaining about this cycle today. The first is the anagen phase, the second is the catagen phase, the third is the telogen phase, and the last but not the least is the exogen phase. Okay, so this is basically a cycle that keeps running around in our head. Okay, anagen phase, I just want to let you all know, hi Rohit. Anagen phase basically is where your hair are actually healthy and they are growing. Okay, they are actually in a state of it's just like started off and it is continuously growing. Okay, that is where we sit on our anagen phase. This phase is generally lasting from between 2 to 8 years. Okay, so this phase is between 2 to 8 years. Then what happens is at one point of time this stops to grow. When it stops to grow, it is called as the catagen phase, that where just stops to grow. It does not, it gets a signal that it's not supposed to grow anymore. And this phase is close to 2 to 4 weeks. Say like around about 2 to 4 weeks, you will have this phase running in your hair. Okay, now the third phase that comes into place is your telogen phase. And your telogen phase basically, the shaft, basically the lower half of the follicle is now moved away from the bulb, whatever was the blood supply. In here it's still in contact with the blood supply, but it's got a signal saying that do not grow any more types. Okay, from here it starts to wither away. That is telogen phase. And another complete phase is exogen phase. So all of these are still in touch with the shaft, the scalp of your face, of your hair, of your head. Okay, so you have your scalp, these are all still in touch with the, hi Vishal, so these are still in touch with the scalp of your in touch with the scalp. Whereas in the exogen phase, it's exactly when you start seeing the hair fall. So when you start seeing the hair fall, it is the exogen phase. Okay, now particularly this does not happen like just from a certain area, like it's not like one certain area will have the anagen phase and then, you know, the telogen phase and then the exogen phase. It basically happens randomly in your hair, and hence you will not get a huge chunk of it falling off together. That means you will not have patchiness per se if it's not a medical condition. Okay, but if it's a medical condition, of course, yes. But if not, then this is randomly happening in all of our hair. Okay, and generally this anagen phase are pretty much plus minus 2 to 8 years, which is happening in all of us round about the same timing. Of course, some of us are 2 years and some of us are 8 years, which is a big difference. But because of this 2 and 8 years, your hair length is better measurement, better measured. Okay, so okay, hi Bina, Prakash, having multiple or are good or single? Having multiple of what? I'm so sorry. Having multiple of hair follicles, the multiple shaft, it is always good because the hair looks thicker, even at a smaller area is going to look thicker. So a lot of people have that. So it's not good or bad in any way. Even your single hair is okay. Generally for a hair transplant, it is much better to have multiple. So yeah. Hi Saurabh. Hi Baljeet. Okay. So I hope I have explained to you all what an overall view of a hair cycle looks like. Okay, so as I was explaining to you all that all of us have a very almost the same amount of time of our anagen and all these other phases. Okay, so what exactly happens in our anagen phase is basically determined by our genetics and by our hormonal levels and the kind of food that we eat. Hence, in the younger age, you would have seen that, oh, my hair used to be so long, they used to grow so long. Or you'll have people say that, oh, you know, I have not taken good care and now look at it, what has happened. This basically obviously deals with a lot of hormones and the kind of food that intake that keeps happening around us and the kind of pollution and all the environmental changes as well. Okay, so that's about hair. That's a little part of it. I've explained to you all that thing. Now let me just explain to you what is an anagen phase again. Anagen phase is basically your growing hair. That is exactly when your hair is growing. Okay, it has just started from the shaft, from the lower half. So this what we see is just the shaft area of it. There must be this part this part that must have been here must have been inside at one point of time, and that starts to come out. Okay, that is when the allergen phase starts. Okay, I have questions. Abhina, I'm going to answer that question in some time. So that's where the hair growth starts, and that becomes a shaft, and now that becomes to the end. Now, of course, there is a concept of you have the hair shaft, and then you have the internal root, which is also growing with it. So all of them, while they're growing, they're merging in together. There are first multiple layers of themselves. Now, by the end, by the time they come out as a shaft, they start to merge together, okay? And this, as you know, is because of keratinin. A keratinin growth is happening in our hair. And that's how we have hair. Okay, so now the anagen phase is happening. The anagen phase is nothing but growing phase of your hair. And as I told you, this can differ between 2 to 8 years in a person, depending on a lot of multiple factors. Okay, so that is one thing one must take in mind. Genetics plays a very, very key role into it, and hormonal and the kind of nutrition. If it is not genetic, then these two can be altered and can be helped out as well. Okay, so one must take that into consideration. Then you have the catagen phase. Catagen phase is a phase where, say, after 8 years. Okay, so I'm going to talk about it later. So in the catagen phase, basically what happens is, of course, that as I've already explained to you earlier as well, each cell of ours has a certain limit. There's a life of every cell of our body. Our hair itself has the same thing. Our hair basically tends to grow, and at one point in time it is going to stop growing because it needs to have the new shaft coming in and the new hair coming in. So the hair, so we have a cutoff, and that they say ki okay, abhi iske baad isko khoon nahi dena hai, and that's when they start to wither. That withering stage is called as catagen phase. Okay, this basically is a resting phase. Your hair is doing nothing but it's just resting. It is not growing, and neither is it attempting to fall off, neither is it trying to die. It is just resting during this phase. This phase is closer to 2 to 4 weeks. All right, then you will have the telogen phase. A telogen phase is very rapid. Basically, it's now moving away from your shaft, from the end of your hair. It's going to move towards the scalp area, and it's going to completely start to wither. Now it is attempting to die. So telogen phase is like completely the growth has stopped and it is now dead. Okay, and the exogen phase means it is completely, that's where the hair fall starts to be shown. On an average, you can have a hair fall of close to 100 to 150, or say from 50 to 150 hair fall are normal. So do not panic when you see that you have so much hair fall. You can have a hair fall of 50 to 150 hair fall strands can fall every day because you have huge amount of hair on your head. All right, so that is the main thing about it. Now I'm going to just see through questions. How to control split ends of hair? So split ends basically is a different, it's not a part of core part of this. Split ends starts to happen when your nutrition is also majorly gone down. Your hair have become frizzy in nature, and there's nothing major you can do. It's only while you are, when your hair is actually growing stage, you should tend to eat good amount of nutrition and make it a point that you sleep well, you exercise well, so that there's a good amount of circulation also that keeps happening. So for split end, you can control it by eating the right type of food. I have explained to you all the good type of food includes eggs, berries, nuts. You can have zinc products. So those basically help your hair grow better. Protein is a very important part of it, and biotin is equally important for your hair. So make it a point that your nutrition getting into your body is right, and that will help you with your hair not getting into split end. Of course, protecting it from the sun, or making it a point that you have physical protection if you're on the car or the bike, not the car, but the bike, or if you tend to keep your windows open, they tend to dehydrate your hair and that becomes a problem. So regularly you must condition your hair as well. Okay. Gurmeet, my age is 48. I am losing my hair falling very fast in recent time. Gurmeet, at the age of 48, if genetics has already played a role, then your hair fall is very difficult to curb. You should start on with your treatments. Something like minoxidil does help, even if it's in a stage where it's about to fall, and it can save the other hair. So you can, Shal is asking if on the bicycle if you can lose hair. Yes, you can lose hair because it's a lot of gush of hair. But of course, your hair are strong enough to protect yourself. But it's the pollution, the environment, the sun, all of these which cause a major factor. So if you are cycling, of course, you should wear a head helmet any which ways to protect your head as well. And yes, on the bicycle also it can cause a problem because it is too much of gush of air for your head. Okay, so you have been advised... Dutasset. So yeah, Dutasset is, you can continue Dutasset. It has shown in some people, Akshay, that hair growth is possible. It can work, but there's a recommended dose for it, of course, and you have to go and see the doctor regularly and find out. What do you mean by harvest? Does it affect? And harvest. Harvest is a tablet? Okay, so it has got basically biotin and other multivitamin, basically harvest capsules. So yes, it's not going to cause any, it's not going to affect your body. For Dutasset, of course, your doctor must have asked you to read in detail as to what exactly it does in your body, but there are side effects which are there of Dutasset as well, but it is just hardly 1-2% of the people. So you need not worry about it. You can just take it, and the moment you feel that there are some changes which are happening which you don't want to see, you can stop it. But people have seen good results with it as well. Okay. I think it's working now. I don't know, I was just suddenly, it looked as I got, it was hanging. Okay, so I have a seborrheic dermatitis, does take some time, and seborrheic dermatitis takes a long time of treatment. It basically involves you cutting down sugar to a very large extent, because seborrheic dermatitis, I don't know if you attended my lecture on dandruff yesterday. So dandruff plays a very key role in seborrheic dermatitis, and seborrheic dermatitis is because of a lot of other things as well, like a very oily scalp. And for people who have a very oily scalp, as I explained yesterday, should tend to have a hair bath every day with a pH balanced shampoo, because it helps in cleaning off the entire stuff. So Deepak, you need to also show it to a physician, because it would involve a long term treatment. It does involve you showing your blood test, because sometimes even a raised uric acid also shows a problem with your head. So you need to take that treatment on. But when it comes to your hair fall is obviously because it is killing your shaft earlier, and you have to tend to keep it cleaner and better so that they grow better. So that is one thing you need to take into consideration. Hi, Smita. Okay, so I am, for once again, for the people who don't want to get bored by me and who have just joined in, I'm just going to again just show you all in brief. Akshay, it can cause a problem for men, and also it can cause impotence as well, but does not happen to everybody. But yes, I'm sure your doctor has asked you to read this on the internet before you have taken the medications. And it is an informed decision. Not everybody has it. In my practice, I have not seen anybody suffering from this. But yes, men do tend to get worried about it. But I have personally not known of somebody who's had a problem. It's in a very small percentage of people that you have a problem. And the dose you're taking is extremely small. So I don't think you should be worried. Okay, Prakash, I have actually had a very good lecture, I think, yesterday on dandruff. If you could just go back into that and you could see the lecture. We have already discussed about dandruff yesterday. Okay, so for people who have come in now, I'm just going to show you all an image. Okay, this is the phase of our hair. Okay, this is how our hair grows and falls off. Your first phase is the anagen phase. Your second phase is the catagen phase. Your third phase is the telogen phase. And your fourth phase is the exogen phase. Okay. So your first phase, okay, is last closer 2 to 8 years. This phase will basically last from 2 to 8 years of your life. So if you like, if you are right now, say 20 years, this hair that you have is probably between, say, 15 years of your age, approximately, like say from 12 to 15 years of your age. And that is one thing. So the hair growth has started that time and it is continuing right now. As everything has to wither away eventually, your hair just tends to give itself a signal saying stop growing, and it stops to grow. This phase, which is the catagen phase, means it is just resting, it is just relaxing itself, it's enjoying its retirement plan, okay, basically. So this is nothing doing, nothing much, it's not getting any blood supply, no, nothing, whatever it is already got, it is just surviving on that, okay. On the third phase is going to be where it's going to stop living. It does not live anymore, it tends to wither away. And in the fourth phase is when it basically leaves the scalp. So as you can see, 1, 2, and 3 is still on the scalp, it's still available on the scalp. So when you tend to comb this hair is going to fall off and it's becoming an exogen phase. Okay, I hope you'll have understood this now. So for people who've just joined in, Siddharam, my hair became white in a small age. My age is 23. So see, once your hair turns white, it is very difficult to turn it back to black. Or but if you are in a graying stage, when your hair is gray, you must take a very keen look into your nutrition. Your nutrition is going to play a very important role. Make it a point that you comb your hair every day, because your combing of your hair basically helps in the circulation of your this is not only for grain, this is also otherwise as well. Circulation is better because of your combing. As I told you, you must rest. You must get good sleep. Sleep plays a very, very, very key role when it comes to your hair. You must exercise, because that again helps in your circulation, and good oxygenated blood reaches all the part of your body. So you must do that. You must stay away from stress. If you are a smoker, please reduce your smoking and kind of just stop it as much as you can, because that also damages your hair. But as your hair is already white, there's nothing much that can be done. As long as there's gray, you can still save your hair, but white hair is very difficult to do that. Okay. Kuljeet, hi. And Prakash, I'm so sorry that I have to ask you to see another show, but please do. Okay, Kuljeet, hi. Nice. Okay, let me see if I missed out something else. Then Vikas, you must start combing your hair back again. Why did you stop combing your hair? You should start combing your hair. So in your anagen phase, when you are in the anagen phase, basically if you start taking minoxidil, it grows better and it stays longer in the anagen phase. Anagen phase is the growing phase, and the growing phase basically means the more manure you give during this growing phase, it's going to help out. That is very, very, very important to understand. If you have got into a stage of telogen phase, or if you're already in a catagen phase, you will suddenly feel that minoxidil is not helping you out, but then you have to give it some rest and realize that once the exogen phase comes in place, you, as you saw in the photo that I just show you, so as your hair gets into the exogen phase, it kind of gets into the anagen phase as well. Okay, so as your hair are also falling off, your early anagen phase is also starting, like the way they've cutely put like a suckling thing, so that it's showing that it's growing, it's going to start growing. Okay, so that is very important for people to understand that in your catagen and telogen phase, you might not see the effect of, say, a PRP treatment or of the minoxidil, but if your face, if your hair, whichever one are in the anagen phase, are going to show much better effect. So you need to calm down. It is okay. It will take another 2-3 months to show effect, additionally to what your doctor must have clarified to you. It is okay for hair. It's a lot of permutation combination because of a lot of things that, you know, are together with it. All right. Okay, thanks, madam. Okay. Kuljeet is asking if hair transplant is successful or not. Hair transplant is... okay, I'm just going to explain a very... I wish I had a ball. Okay, I'm going to search for a ball. Okay. We do have a lot of soft toys with us, so yeah. Okay, so I'm going to show you an example of this particular sheep that I have. Okay, so now in your head, this is not helpful. Okay, in your head, basically, okay, I'll take the sheep again. Okay. Okay, in your head, this is, say for example, this is your head, okay? And there would be two phases in it. We have two parts of our head. One is so-called, as the doctor would explain to you, as a donor, and one would be the recipient, okay? Now, the recipient ones, which are generally what we see, is that moon wala hair fall, like, you know, you see that, which basically happens. So, say like a moon phase which is happening here, okay? Your back hair generally is not at all affected by the testosterone levels in your body. These hair, when picked up and put into your normal hair strands in the other head side, which were that those hair were affected by your testosterone. Now, these hair are not affected by testosterone. These become your donor and this part of your head becomes your recipient. Okay. Now, as a donor part, they're going to pick up those hair from your corner or from the lower half of your head and are going to start putting it on the top over here. Now, the simple concept that you must remember is that how much of your hair fall is going to happen, your doctor cannot predict. कि आपके पापा को पूरा मून चांद था या आधा चांद था या कितना चांद था दे कैन नॉट एक्सप्लेन दे डोंट नो इट ओके एंड नाइदर कैन यू प्रिडिक्ट इट ओके सो अज्यूमिंग दैट आई हैव डन से माय हेयर ट्रांसप्लांट योर ओके दिस अमाउंट ऑफ पार्ट आई हैव डन माय हेयर ट्रांसप्लांट बट इफ द हेयर फॉल वाज सपोज टू हैपन फ्रॉम योर टू योर ओके That phase is going to continue and it is going to happen at some point of time or the other. That does not mean that your hair transplant has been a failure. It just simply means you need round two. In the round two, you will again take from your donors and you will again put it here. Now, the concept is that there are your recipient obviously has to be less than your donor because you can't put all your hair over here and not have nothing behind. Okay. So that has to be managed out and that basically helps us out in getting your full hair growth. So many a times when you do say, for example, only this is the part you have done. Okay. And now you know that this much is going to go. You should get into regular PRP treatments, regular minoxidil treatments. You must do all of these things because they help you out. And they will save whatever other hairs that you have, which are affected by testosterone. Okay. I'm going to have a detailed topic about hair transplant as well, but this is just an overview. And it being successful or not, of course, depends a lot on your nutrition as well. But once your hair transplant is of a non-testosterone layer to the testosterone layer, which is now not the testosterone one, it is going to be a good effect. Okay. Okay. Subha Reddy, hi, I'm facing hair problem. Small pimples are on the head. Okay, your hair fall problem would have to do depending on what. I have already explained to you all the entire phases of hair and depending on where your hair lies. But of course, good nutrition, sleeping well, not taking stress, working out, combing your hair, all of these are equally important. What can we do to get our hair healthy? I'm 33. Okay, Kuljeet. What you can do to get healthy hair is, as I'm telling again, no stress, sleeping well, eating your right food, like not eating too much junk food. Of course, as I always say, stay away from packaged food. Like once in a blue moon is okay to go and eat and binge around. But in your regular food, you should be having high fibrous food. You should be consuming a lot of water in the day, consuming vitamin C in the day. It really helps your hair grow better. There's another concept which is hair fall due to pregnancy. Because your body is in so much stress, many a time you would find that during pregnancy, your hair fall happens. And this is a normal phase and it can happen in case of pregnancy. For some women, it happens post-pregnancy as well. So it is normal to get through that phase and to be in that phase, and you have to wait for that entire thing to go away, because this is very much, it's on a very hormone level, and you per se can't do anything much during your pregnancy phase or say during your lactation phase for your hormones, because it is what it is. You can't take too many tablets. You can't try to rectify anything. So that is one thing. Okay. I'm also having hair fall problem. I have been explaining that. I hope, Sidharam, you have. Is there a possibility to regrow the hair? I am in level 2 baldness. Then hair transplant is a good option for you, Saurav, and you can go for hair transplant as well. Okay. Okay, Akshay is asking, I don't know if Parvez is watching this. So a friend of mine named Parvez has recently told me about this treatment called as Hijama. And I have asked him to go for the treatment so that I know if it works or no. So Akshay's question is, I saw a treatment called Hijama on YouTube, which grows hair. A treatment in which they give a small cut of the hair scalp and apply suction cups, which suck the blood and increase the circulation of the hair, and it is recommended. Akshay, I don't know about this treatment as much, but the treatment actually is very similar to what we do as PRP treatment. As a matter of fact, PRP is a more scientific treatment, and I'm not sure about Hijama. So I will not comment if it's good or bad or whatever, but I would say that a PRP treatment is a much better, is a much higher quality of treatment, because it's a lot of centrifuging and it's a lot of proper taking out of the proper platelets that we need. See, the concept is the same. They are going to give you some small scars. These scars, basically what they're going to do is they're going to ooze out blood. There's no concept of bad blood, and okay, then you can't get bad blood out from your head. Okay, like it's I don't know how, what is happening. I don't know why people are calling it good or bad blood, but basically it just means your veins, the impure blood of your veins are basically being cut. You can't cut your arteries because you'd be just flowing all over the place. So they just make small cuts in the veins. This basically would have the similar concept of having platelets, but it won't be as concentrated as if you would have to do a PRP treatment. Okay. Of course, they are doing the suction to get as much as blood centric towards that particular area. I am not sure about the treatment, but what I am aware of, how we treat people, is PRP treatment. So if you go for Hijama treatment, please let me know. I know the, like, I don't even know, like, if doctors are performing the Hijama treatment, so I'm not aware of it. And when it comes to injectables, especially in your scalp, I do recommend, like, generally I don't mind, even if you're, like, I say that there are parallel medicines as well, and one can go towards it. But when it comes to something that involves your head or any of your part of your body getting injected or having something pierced in your body, please go to a proper doctor, because it involves a very high level of hygiene. It involves a lot of understanding of those hygiene conditions and why is it important and how to maintain it. So it is very important that you consider it and look into it. So I would request you to think of a second shot, because if this goes wrong, the procedure just sounds layman to me. And if that goes wrong, it can be a problem. So if Parvez is watching, I'm sorry, Parvez, but that's what I feel. Okay, Meena is asking me a question. As we age, does hair reduce the speed of growth? Yes, because it reduces in terms of, because of the kind of hormones, because of the kind of diet we change into. And yes, and hence, it can reduce the speed of growth, and it can have, we could probably get into a telogen phase faster, and of course then the exogen phase even much faster. Okay. Vikas is asking me, does oil, regular oil, help? Wow, I have a lot of questions today. Okay. So I had a very nice discussion about this as well with a colleague today, and the thing about oil is, if you see what traditionally was done with oil, was they used to wash their hair with Rita and Shikikai and whatever, and then the oiling was done. So now you need to understand what the concept is. The body cannot absorb oil, and either it cannot do anything. Matlab, you can't have a metabolic reaction happening right here. Okay, all your nutrients of your body are getting in from your blood supply. Okay, so your nutrients from your body have to go, right? So the shaft is not going to, your shaft is pretty low. So your hair oil or your oiling is not going to get inside at all. Okay. Oily hair and conditioning your hair. Okay. It will condition your hair very well. So you can use it on your shaft of your hair and it's going to help you condition that hair. Okay. So oil does that. Okay. The other concept was they used to wash their hair first. And after they were done with washing, they used to oil their hair. Now, what were this? What is the difference between the two of them? What we do is we go through the entire day not oiling. Like say your entire day, you are out on the bike. You're out on the bike. You are basically in the polluted area. You have dust, particles, everything. You have air conditioners and all of that stuff together. Okay. And now you have this oil which has been now, or you have this dust which has come on your head, and now that particular dust or head problem is now you're trapping it whilst you oil your hair, okay? Whereas the other concept was after cleaning your hair, they were oiling it. So that was causing a different barrier. The barrier was hair washed, you have your oil, and now uske oil ke upar, even if there was dust or something attached, they were just washing it off again. And again, they were oiling it. We are doing it the other way around, which is not good for our hair. You should be basically using it for your shaft. It basically helps in conditioning your hair. Okay. Jay Prakash. Hello. Smita, please tell me. Please let me know. Is it a good to continue oiling for a complete week and taking head bath only 2 times in a week? No. No, Smita, that is not good. Your oiling should be only... Your oiling should be only for 2 hours maximum, because it's going to cause more problem on your skin as well. So it is better off that you oil your hair for 2 hours. No problem. You can do it from your shaft to your whatever to your... Nothing is going to get absorbed from your hair follicles on top. You will only be doing damage. So you can consume whatever you want to consume, which is good for your health, but hair directly is not going to help you out. Okay. So that is not good. You should just say you're going out somewhere. Just... apply your oil for like 2 hours and that's about it. Doctor, applying castor oil gives growth as in parlor if the eyes, eyebrows are not even not in, they suggest. Castor oil is such a, what do you call that? It's such a viscous oil. I mean, you try applying it on your head. Of course, I have also gone through the entire phase of trying all these permutation combinations. Taking that oil out of your head is another headache. So I don't even recommend it. And I don't know how it's acting on the eyebrows as well. So I'm not really sure. Okay. Siddharth, is my hair became white. So is it safe to use color using Garnier or Godrej dye or black it again to make it black again? Okay, since your hair is white and of course you're just 23 years of age, so you don't have any option but to color your hair. Though I see a lot of men nowadays are really flaunting the salt and pepper look as what they call it. So if you can flaunt it, why not? If like I have seen some guys doing that, which looks good. But if you don't want to, of course you can color your hair. But I don't know which company is good. Is it Garnier or is it Godrej? I'm not the better judge for it, so I would not tell you. But you've come to a point where you have to color your hair, and I'm not denying it. So you should look out for, of course, non-ammonia coloring hair stuff, and look out for something which is not going to be damaging your hair, and making it a point that the thing is done from a right place and not at home. If you don't know how to do it, don't get done from a friend. Learn how, like... understand more about it and then go ahead with it is what my recommendation would be. For washing off your hair, it's always a shampoo. Please don't go for soap. Soap is not good for your hair. If you tend to wash your hair every day, even Vikas has asked a question, should we shampoo hair every day or once a week? On a normal thing that we discuss, your hair should be shampooed between 2 to 3 times a week. Nothing more. But if you have something which is a very oily scalp, then what we recommend is that you do, or you can wash your hair every day. If you're one of those guys who are in a habit of washing your hair every day, just putting water on your head is not going to help. So don't tend to do that at all. Kise pani se dho liya, that makes your hair worse. Use a pH balanced shampoo if you are washing your hair every day. The shampoo that you're supposed to use is called as a pH balanced shampoo. A pH balanced shampoo is not going to remove any oil from your hair. So don't apply oil and then try to take out your hair oil from a pH balanced shampoo. You will finish off the entire bottle worth 1000 rupees and will not going to help you a lot. So please understand that as well. A pH balanced shampoo just has to be used on the scalp and not on the shaft. You don't need to. It's not going to harm your hair, but it is not required. So just don't do that. So that is very important. So I hope I have helped you all out today with the hair cycle and understanding how the cycle works of our hair and what exactly happens to our hair. As I've told you already, that genetics plays a key role in all of this. Your hormones, as we grow older, the hormones tend to change, and hence your entire hair, the type of your hair that you had earlier and now, it becomes different. You would have stress and all of that thing. You need to sleep very well, comb your hair, exercise. So all of those things are very important. So pH balanced shampoo examples would be something like a Sebamed shampoo. The Sebamed shampoos are pH balanced shampoos. You can also just go to your chemist and find out, you can just ask them for a pH balanced shampoos. As I even told you earlier yesterday itself, that a pH balanced shampoo is not going to smell good. So don't expect it's going to be like, wow, and you're feeling good when you're having a bath. No, it does not even lather as much. So you have to be aware that it does not lather as much. It does not, you don't have it as the other effect. Like if you use a Pantene shampoo, the way it lathers and the way a pH balanced shampoo lathers are two different things. It's like a scalp cleanser. That's it. It just cleanses the scalp. It's not into shampoo. It's not into creating a surfactant or something. It's just cleansing your scalp in the right manner. So somebody who uses or wants to wash their hair every day should use a pH balanced shampoo. All right. I hope I have helped you all out today with this particular topic. Our topic for tomorrow is, if I'm not wrong, anti-aging treatments, and Botox is going to be the discussion for tomorrow. So I hope you'll enjoy the discussion tomorrow as well. It is a long thought that it's only for women, but no, men also nowadays do amazing Botox treatment and they look amazing. So the men and the women can obviously attend the lectures and need not have to think that they're attending for their wife or their mother or their child. They basically can attend for themselves as well. It's about anti-aging, and that is what will be our discussion for tomorrow. All right, so let me say a goodbye to y'all, and I'm so thankful to all of y'all for attending my lecture today or session today, and it's been an amazing session, and I do enjoy all these question answers as always. Keep sending your love to us, and do attend our Up Chalega India, the step challenge that we're having, India Step Challenge. Please participate. You can win up to 5 lakh rupees and lots of goodies, and it's going to be a lot of fun. So please be a part of it. And as I always say, be kind to one another. Do one act of gratitude every day. And with GOQii, be the force. So take care of yourselves, and thank you again for spending your time with me. Bye.